Okay, welcome to the presentation. Today we're going to be covering NinjaTrader 8. I'm from Daytradetowin, and this is a presentation that will show you how to download NinjaTrader, how to install it, how to use the charts, how to use the dome, all the important features you'd want to know, whether you're coming from NinjaTrader 7 or if you're brand new to NinjaTrader. Okay, let's go over installing an indicator. On the Daytradetowin website, we've got some free downloads. So let's go up to the software area. By the way, Daytradetowin.com is the website. Type that in your browser. Go to the free downloads area on the software menu. We have the news indicator for NinjaTrader, and you can download it for Ninja 7 or Ninja 8. I'm going to install the NinjaTrader 8 version here momentarily. What is the news indicator? Well, it shows you news events on your chart, and that's important because news events can affect how the market behaves. If you have a really big news event that's about to come out, the market can get really volatile and you might want to stay out. So the news indicator can prepare you for that activity. Keep in mind that it's only going to show you planned events, so if there's some major political event or some global catastrophe of some kind, you won't see that probably in the indicator. You're just going to see a jobless report or the head of the Fed speaking. Let's install the indicator. You download it from the website. It would download to your downloads folder in Windows. Remember, Control J can bring you to your downloads easily. You can click Show in Folder, and that will put you right in your downloads folder. You can see that I've already downloaded the news indicator right here. So that makes it pretty easy to import. Now, importing indicators is actually tricky for a lot of people, but we can make it pretty simple just with a few steps here. So in the Windows operating system, a path is kind of like how you get to a file or a folder. So this is the path to my downloads folder. It's in C, Users, Admin, Downloads. Your path will probably be different. If you bought your computer and you typed in your name here, you'd probably have Bill or John or whatever instead of Admin. So I'm going to need to give NinjaTrader this path to import this news indicator. So the quick way to do that is to click this area up here. Now, I'm using Windows 10. Your Windows might be a little bit different, but generally your downloads would be in C, Users, your username for Windows, then Downloads. If you open up an Explorer window, you can usually see the Downloads area right here on the right-hand side, and that will tell you, that will put you right in the Downloads folder. But what I recommend doing is clicking up here. It's automatically highlighted. We're going to do Control C to copy. That means this path is copied to our clipboard. We can simply import the indicator by going to NinjaTrader's Control Center. Now, how do we get there? We don't see the Control Center anymore. We just see the chart. Well, down here in Windows, you've got the taskbar, this whole area on the bottom. In the taskbar, we've got this nice little icon here for NinjaTrader 8. So if we hover over this icon, we can select between the charts that we have open, the dome windows, all the other nice things that NinjaTrader provides. But we're going to click on the Control Center. And this brings up the Control Center. So it's now in front of our chart. We're going to drop down the chart so there's no confusion, and we want to look at one thing. So we're importing an indicator right now. So to import that indicator, we need to go to Tools, Import, NinjaScript add-on. Why is it not called indicator? Well, because indicators are written in a language called NinjaScript, so the NinjaTrader people decided to call it a NinjaScript add-on. So click on NinjaScript add-on, and now we can click on the downloads button right here, or we can use our handy shortcut. See, click on downloads, it's right there. Let's go back to where we were. We can paste in the path. So Control V, we'll paste the path, see Users, Admin, Downloads, click on Open, that opens up the folder, click on the indicator that you want to import, in this case the Daytradetowin News Indicator, then click on Open. This is a normal message that will appear. It's warning you that indicators can do bad things if it's a bad indicator. We don't have to worry about that, so click on OK. And then there should be a success message if everything goes OK. And there it is. So the indicator is now imported. Now at this point, we can go back to the chart and add the indicator to the chart. So to do that, remember, right-click, indicators, double click on the market, or sorry, not the market, the indicator that you want to import. This indicator is named Daytradetowin News Indicator. So we're going to go to the D section. As a shortcut, I'm going to click on one of these and hit the D key. That will jump me right to the D's. I'll scroll down a little bit more. Let's see. There it is. DTDW 8 News 4T. We try to name our indicators the same. So what you have downloaded is probably what you'll need to look for in that list. Okay, now let's double click on the indicator, just like the other indicators. And it jumps down here, which means we can now configure it. So there's a few settings here that we can configure. Each indicator is different. Each indicator will do a different thing. So this indicator plots news events. Therefore, its settings or properties or parameters, whatever you want to call them, all this stuff right here will reflect that. You can configure the maximum number of news events that will appear to 15. We'll take a look at the indicator here first. Let's click on apply. All right. So we can change this to a smaller number. Let's say we only want 5 news events to appear because we don't want that much clutter on our chart. Okay, only 5 news events are now appearing. So it's really that simple using this indicator. You can customize the colors as well. There's a big list of colors here. Your individual color preferences might be different, or you might be using a white chart and for your eyes green might be too harsh or you can't see it. Change it to a darker color on this list. Set it up however you want to. Thank you everyone for attending, and if you have any more questions, let us know.